host. My name is Shaniqua Robinson, and I will be your host. And so firstly, I want to thank every single platform that's allowed us to stream from Anchor, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, Listen Notes, Podbay, Podbean, and now Amazon Music. Thank you, thank you, thank you to everyone who has been sending words of encouragement, your prayers, your encouragement. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It's so much appreciated. We do appreciate the love. Just a few things. Thank you all for everyone who has supported the book. I did have a promo that went from Sunday into Tuesday. Many people downloaded during that time that it was a free download. So thank you for everyone who did that. We are currently very, very close to making it to 1,000 streams. So thank you everyone who has supported this journey from the first time until today. You guys know that on Soulful Soul Care Sundays, it's just kind of a kickback. So just in that, when I first started this, I actually did not have any idea that it was going to go the way that it did. I just felt God leading me to record a message at that time that was entitled Overcoming Discouragement and Disappointment. I sent it to a few people that were close to me. One of my friends that I sent it to, she was like, this is good. She's like, you need to do this on a different app. And when she said that to me, that's when she gave me the information for Anchor. And I went to Anchor, put it on Anchor, and then it just went off from there. And so from one stream, and that wasn't even on, it was on Buzzsprout. I don't even use them anymore, but they're really good. I started off with them. But from one potential episode to all of these different episodes and now 1,000 streams, that's amazing. Thank you so much. In the midst of a pandemic, and you know, I don't have a huge platform yet. It's growing, so I'm very, very grateful for where God has brought us. And so today, talking from the topic of change in me, changing me, know that we are in the mask off season, so I really wanted to dig deep into that. And then talking about different things pertaining to the transition that took place from when I was a young child and then even to where I am right now. And so it didn't all happen overnight. It's completely, and even still now, still so many different layers that we're going through, so many different things that we're going through. One thing that I can be blessed and say is that all throughout my life, throughout my journey, God has sent amazing people, men and women of God, to pour into me at different specific times. I am blessed to know some amazing people. I am so blessed to know them. I mean, to have had encounter with them, to had conversation with them, had gained wisdom from them. But even in all of that, there's still so much that I am learning. There's still so much that I am growing into. And so this Soulful Soul Care Sunday, though it's just a kickback, is to help you to know that your journey is just that, your journey. And so you may not get it when someone else gets it, and you may not get as far as someone else does, but if you keep on paving the way for wherever you are. See, my story is that I don't have, my father's not a pastor, my mother's not an evangelist. I mean, they've never taken on clergy roles. They may have done some things inside of the church, but nobody actually took the complete role as a person of faith. If we go back in history, my grandfather, who was my mom's father, was a pastor. And if we go back even further, my grandmother's grandmother, this is my maternal side now, she was a pioneer. She was a very, very strong woman of the faith. And my cousin, who was on Reverend Pierce, he could attest to that because he comes through that bloodline and he's flowing in his gifts in the Chicago area. But so she did lay some groundwork for us. But for the most part, as to, and this is something that if you guys go back and listen to that interview, Reaching the Millennial Generation, this is something we talked about in that conversation, is that, you know, we did have cousins and people that went forth before us that did their, you know, they did their due diligence in the faith, but we have to do our own. And so I know that what God has given me is specifically different. And so even with my cousin, what he encouraged me in saying, he said, you want to walk in your own stilettos. And so with being your own person, knowing that you have to, this is encouragement to somebody that's listening in. Your story may not be someone else's story, but you can grab inspiration from those stories and knowing that if they did it, then so can you. You just got to keep on at it. You got to keep going. You got to keep, you know, keep pressing. Don't give up despite whatever comes your way. Now, the hardest thing about that, and the reason that I can resonate so much with Apostle Paul, is that when you are paving the way and you have a past and you have a history, it is hard because you don't really have many people that are closely to you that you can pull from. And then if you do have people that come from the same past, they're fighting their own things too. So the time that they can give over to you to help you fight your battles, just like when Jesus, when he was bearing his cross, Simon came and helped him to bear to bear the cross with him. And it was said that he was a person of color, Simon was. But he helped him to bear the cross with him. But all of us have to bear our own crosses, every single one of us. There's a scripture that says, if any man to follow Jesus, take up your cross daily. Meaning that this is something that I have to bear for the sake of my call. Deny yourself and take up your cross daily. Now, you don't see many people that talk about the denying yourself part, especially in this generation. I was talking to one of my sisters this week. She's probably about 7 years or so older than myself. But, you know, and when you meet her, she's very humble, very, very, very humble person. And one thing in knowing her is that she's a wealth of information, does well with the business that she has been given, is, you know, a good steward of her home. And she doesn't come with all these theatrics. You know, there's a lot of people that have theatrics and they have all of these other, you know, things, but they don't have the goods. And this is a good person, but she don't come with all that extra, you know, stuff with her. And that was just a learning lesson for me. But anyways, with having conversation with her on, you know, some time ago, and then we conversed on this week, when you're a new person, especially a young person, and you're trying to take this, you know, this walk seriously, you won't have many young friends. I have a handful of young people. And what I've been doing most recently is I've been on Clubhouse. I know people started talking about Clubhouse some time ago, but I didn't get into the mix. I actually just started doing Clubhouse recently. And I'm blessed by the groups that I sit in, because there's different facets to who I am as a person. That's another thing I want to say to encourage someone, that you are spiritual. You're not Donald Lawrence has a song that you're not a natural being having a spiritual experience, but you're a spiritual being having this natural experience. So you are absolutely, completely spiritual. But there are things to you that God interwove in your DNA that make you you. And so with that, you know, I write music. I wouldn't consider myself to be the next, as far as songstress, the next Whitney Houston or anything like that. But I know that God has given me the ability to create songs. And so I put myself in spaces where there are people that are similar, there are people that actually have the same goals, the same dreams. I sat in on an ally meeting for people of color to help with the policing and different things that are going on with the police system, and how we could help, you know, people of color that have been brutalized by the system, that have been victims of the system. And so these are things that I'm passionate about, because I have, my family has incurred this, and then I have witnessed it, and, you know, just trying to do something about it to implement change. And so this is all under the same umbrella of change in me, changing me. Yes, go get inspired. Yes, go get encouraged. But spend a lot of time with God. As much as you can. I never tell people to follow my regimen, because when I first got into this, and it's hard to believe, but people that were close to me, and it was probably only two or three people, that being the woman of God that taught me so much around that time. I mean, I'm not saying, when I say close to me, I mean inside of my home. I mean, when God blessed me to have my own home, aside from, you know, premarital, I didn't have a relationship in this home. It was just me and my children, you know, shutting down my social media and just spending time in the Word of God, listening to people that preach the Word of God clearly, praying and different things like that. When you tell, that's hard to tell somebody to cut off everything and just spend time with God, especially when you first come in from the world. But this is what I did. But I had to be led of God to do that, because it's not a natural thing to just cut off all of those different things. Sometimes I just go into a fast as a drop of a hat. I don't make a major announcement unless I need someone. I feel like this is a hard one. I may need someone to pray for me. I fasted for 4 days and 4 nights. I mean, no food, just liquids. That's not, you know, that's not boastable, because that's not what my goal was. But to look at the fact that I was able to do it, and it's been time previously that I had not been able to do that. This is a process. Everything is a process. And so I want to encourage you all going into this week, know that the change in you that the Holy Spirit is doing in you, it's a process. And it, you know, your process may be different from someone else's, but it helps when you can link up with people that can encourage you, that can motivate you, that can inspire you on your journey, so that you don't give up and go, I mean, where is there to go to? Where is there to go to? I was speaking to one young lady and she was telling me that she had denounced the Christian faith. This broke my heart because when I had seen her, she was singing in church, you know, looked as if she really, you know, loved God. She's young, of course, and she went to college, and she said that they, you know, she was awakened in college. This is where she had her awakening experience, where she learned. Now she's so knowledgeable that she doesn't believe. And she said, you know, it's some hypocrisies in the church. There's some dangers in the church. And I had to let her know it's more dangerous in the world. And that's real. That is very, very real, because there's no safety net. But, you know, I mean, there's no but to that. There is no safety net. When I did have my experience when I was working at the casino, I thought to myself, you know, I'm going to put my cross chain on and my cross earrings. And I'm working as a beverage server, knowing that this is against what it is that God is for. And, you know, I'm just like, I just need to make some money, and I'm in an environment that's completely against what it is that I believe in. And eventually I had to cut ties with that, but when I did cut ties with it, God opened up the door so quickly for me to transition into the medical field, and I was getting paid a good salary. And so that's just me stepping out on faith, and that's just something for someone. I don't know, maybe that was for you. Just know that your process is a process. We're learning every single day. There are different things that I'm still learning about God, about this walk. And as I learn, I teach my children. With parenting your children, I read a post that said people think that once you parent your children, it's done when they're young. But when they become adults, that's when you really have to get down on your knees and be in prayer for them. And as they're growing, you know, I'm just realizing, you know, our time is, these children are growing quickly. But I was listening to a young brother this week, and he was talking about how his mother had given herself over to her desire, and how it impacted him and impacted his brother. And to hear a man say this, you know, it was heartbreaking for him, even still heartbreaking for him today. And it just let me know the importance of the role of the mother. Yes, it's a sacrificial role. It's a sacrificial role. But God reward. I believe that if you stay faithful to it, that God will be faithful to you. Because it's very important what we do with His children, that He has trusted us with, that He has given to us. And so, yeah, but one thing in that conversation, it's many of us, we were on a clubhouse, when he was crying out in his own way, because, you know, men are more aggressors, they're more aggressive, there were other men that jumped in to help to heal him in that moment. And that was beautiful for me, because you don't really see that often. You hear a lot of tearing each other down, and I'm quick to beat you down or bring you down, but really that's insecurity, because the only reason you have to bring someone else down is because you don't feel good about yourself or within yourself. But there's a song he said, I go to my brothers and I go downtown. What? Somebody keep telling me, don't come around. What's the song? It's been a long time coming, but I know a change is going to come. And I found myself knocked right back down to the ground. That song, I just went into a moment because listening to that, even that song, it, you know, when you're reaching out for help, there's sometimes that people reach out to help. I have reached out for help, and then you don't get the response that you're expecting. But even in that, don't be dismayed and get upset with people because they don't meet your need at that moment. Reach up for God with even the injustices that we face in this world today. The only person that's able to trump everything that's going on, the only person that's able to override all of the sickness, all of the woes, all of the everything is God. God and God all by himself. The blood of Jesus. That is our defense. When I was sitting, I remember I was sitting, and sometimes it can be discouraging because there are probably different things that I desired I could got from people that were close to me, but in either case. And I'm in prayer, and I have all of these books. I have a bookshelf. And I just felt God leading me to, you know, you're upset because you don't know this, or you're upset because this is something that you may be lacking in, but this is all of the information that you need is readily available to you so that you can learn. I know that it's hard, and I know that this is not the way that you would have preferred to learn it, but right now I'm all you got. For many people, God is all that you have. He's all that you have. You can't afford to lose your faith. You can't afford to lose your faith in God because He's all that you have. And he has said, even in his word, apart from me, you can do nothing. So a lot of people that's out here, you know, they think that they're doing something, but if you listen to all these celebrities, they crying out now. And they're saying, like, this stuff is, you know, this is not what you all think it is up here. It's not. It's not. And so, notice that change that God is doing in you and the way that he's changing you. If you've opened your heart and you open yourself, he made yourself readily available for you. It's a process. Available to him, it's a process. And he's going to work everything out, and he's going to work it out so much so that he begins to remove your desires, transform them, change them. Now, the danger in that is reconnecting with people who have not allowed him to change their taste buds yet. So then they want to spark out that old, you know, spark that up in you because they want to see that side of you. But that's not beneficial to you. So you got to have enough wisdom to know that, yeah, I probably can't talk to you as often as I would probably want to. Though I don't mind, you know, hashing out these certain things. I know that this is not conducive to my spiritual growth. And this is not going to help me to continue in the path that God has set for me. As for myself, I'm not the only one that's counting. You know how they, in the movie Mulan, one of my favorite little animated films, she went on behalf of her father because he was too old to go to the army, but he was still willing to go. But she went on behalf of him. But even in her going on behalf of him, it was one person, one representative that went from every single home. And she chose to be the one to come from her home to represent her home. You represent your home. I know you didn't sign up for this, but you're qualified. You can do it. You're well equipped. God has anointed you. He's chosen you. And the change he's doing in you is going to benefit them, even though they may be ungrateful, even though they may not see your sacrifice, even though you may be cooking meals every day for everyone. You may be the one that everybody always call on. You may be the one that they always stand in need of. And it's like, how much can I do? How much can I do? But the more you expand your capacity to be a blessing to others, God will pull. You cannot be God blessing a person that blesses others. That is unselfish. That's not selfish. That doesn't just consider themselves, but considers others. You open yourself up to him, and he knows that what he's getting ready to deposit into your life, what he's getting ready to bless you with, is not just going to benefit you, it's going to benefit everybody else. He's going to continue to bless you. There are many things that I don't know that I'm still learning. I have so many questions in regards to different things. And I know there's probably things that I probably won't know until I meet him. Even in that, I'm not going to give up on him. It's gotten a lot more different. There are some great things waiting, but there are some other things waiting too. And that's why it's important for us to be connected to one another, because you may know something that someone else doesn't know, and then they may know something that you do not know. This is the entire point of this message, is just to encourage you to just keep going in your process, knowing that he's doing a change in you and that he's changing you. And, you know, don't let outside forces or people try to convince you that he hasn't done any work in you. People from my past that knew me, some of the things that they say now is, oh, she, you know, she changed. And many people say it in a negative way because they like the way that you used to be. Some people are proud. Many people are prouder now because they see that this is, you know, definitely something that I've committed myself to. But I've yet to even touch the brim on what it is that God fully wants to do. And so let that be encouragement to you, that he's doing a change in you, he's changing you, and that it's a process. Everybody's process is different. Your process is different. What God has called you to do is different. What he's anointed you to do is different. What he's chosen you to do, it's different. And so you may have to go through different things that other people may not. But don't forsake the assembly of saints. Stay close to your church home. That community is powerful. It's powerful within itself. You could only imagine how powerful it is to have that community of faith walkers, believers. And stay close to your family. I know some people have struggles in their family, different things going on in their families that is not of God. Sometimes that requires you to have be separated. And if that's the case, then I just pray that God puts you with people that are safe so that you don't have to endure that. And just know that Jesus loves you. You know, you have a friend in me. This is a no judgment zone. I had a sister in Christ to reach out to me earlier this week. It's completely a no judgment zone. We can talk. I have my information readily available. Yeah, so that's it. That's all I have for you all on this Soulful Soul Care Sunday. Know that God is changing you. He's doing a change in you. And just let him do it. Continue to let him do the work in you. Don't be manipulated. Don't be don't let people take advantage of you because they see the purity of you really seeking to be different. Some people will try to use that as naiveness. And because they know that there are certain things you're not aware of, they try to take advantage of you. Don't let that be the case. I pray to God that don't be the case for you, but that he makes you wise along with, you know, the process, so that you don't have people that are coming in just to snoop or coming in just to try to bring you down or coming in just to take advantage of you. That's it. Father, how we thank you and praise you for this opportunity that you have given us to speak on the Soulful Soul Care Sunday. Father, we thank you for the change that you're doing in us. We thank you for the change that you're doing in this world because you're doing a work in us. Father, we pray now in the name of Jesus, God, that there be no knowledge or wisdom that is withheld from us in this season, God, that you pour out your spirit, as you said in your word, that in the last days you will pour out your spirit upon all flesh, that the old man may dream dreams and the young man may see visions, God. We pray, Father God, that even with this, that you give us understanding so that we can be able to interpret what it is that is going on in this season, that we may be of a better benefit to the body of Christ, the body of believers, and also to our families, to those who are close to us. God, we bless you and we praise you for being God and God all by yourself. We know that it's only by your grace that we have come this far. And Father, that we know that even in that, you're going to continue to lead us on. Father, we thank you for loving us. We thank you for keeping us. We thank you for wrapping your loving arms protection around us. We thank you for your double shield of protection that is covering us. We thank you for your angels that you have dispatched all around us to fight off all dangers seen and unseen. Your ministering angels that minister to our mind, our bodies, and our spirits. God, we thank you. Hallelujah, God, for being a shield. Hallelujah, God, for being our strong tower. Hallelujah, God, for being our all in all, Father. Everything that we need is in you, Father. We thank you for being everything to us. And we just pray that in this season, God, that we continue to yield ourselves over to you all the more, that we may bear this fruit that may abound, that you may get the glory out of our lives. It's in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus, God, that we do seal this prayer, and we thank you for being God and God all by yourself. Hallelujah and amen. We lift you high.
Somebody just open up your mouth and say that. Say, let all the other names fade.
We lift you higher. We lift you higher.
the other name fade away. Jesus. Let all the other names fade away. Sing that out till there's only you. Sing. Let all. Just tell them, Jesus, take. Jesus, take your place. Jesus, take your place. One more time, every voice lift it up. Sing. Let all the other names. Let all the other names. There's no other name that's higher than the name of Jesus. Oh, till there's only you. Just tell me, Jesus, take your place. Jesus, just sing like this. You say, so like a fire. Like a flood, come. Come however you want, God. Come with your power, with your power. Just tell them with your love. You can come however you want to come. However you want. One more time, just sing. Sing like a flood. However you want. Can you just tell him tonight, Holy Spirit, you can have your way in my life. I'm surrendered. My heart is abandoned to you tonight. And you can come however you want. Come however you want. Yeah. One more time, church, just say like this. Let all the other names fade. Jesus.